Welcome to World Mission Topics, Lesson 12. Today's topic is Open Our Eyes. The lesson text is coming out of Genesis chapter 21, verses 14 through 19. 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 12 through 17. Numbers chapter 22, verses 21 through 34. Ephesians chapter 1, verses 17 through 18. Psalms 119, verse 18. And Luke chapter 10, verse 23. The memory verse is Psalms 119, verse 18. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw. And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. And that's 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 17. Psalms 119, verse 18, open thou my eyes that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. The key verses for today's lesson, spiritual sight, spiritual revelation. Spiritual sight, seeing but not seeing, or seeing two things at once, both equally real and in different realms, both here and there. In a spiritual dimension, spiritual revelation. In its broad meaning, revelation is divine guidance of inspiration. It is the communication of truth and knowledge from God to his children on earth, suited to their language and understanding. It simply means to uncover something not yet known. Open our spiritual eyes. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Opening our spiritual eyes to revelation will bring powerful moments to our lives. And that's Ephesians chapter 1, verses 17 through 18. Revelation is the key to authority. Peter received the keys of the kingdom after he received the revelation that Jesus was Christ. And that's Matthew chapter 16, verse 16. Hagar and Ishmael, provision in the wilderness. And Abraham rose up early in the morning and took bread and a bottle of water and gave it unto Hagar, putting it on her shoulder, and the child and sent her away. And she departed and wandered in the wilderness at Beersheba. And the water was spent in the bottle, and she cast the child under one of the shrubs. And God heard the voice of the lad, and the angel of God called to Hagar out of heaven and said unto her, What aileth thee, Hagar? Fear not, for God hath heard the voice of the lad where he is. And God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. And she went and filled the bottle with water and gave the lad drink. And that's Genesis chapter 21, verse 19. Hagar and her son were cast out in the wilderness without much provision. When their water ran out, Hagar wept. God heard the lad's voice. He instructed Hagar. He opened her eyes. In the midst of our grief or hard times, he will not only comfort us, but open our natural and spiritual eyes to heavenly answers. Elisha and the servant, protection. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early and gone forth, behold, a host come past the city, both with horses and chariots. And his servant said unto him, Alas, my master, how shall we do? And he answered, Fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes, that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw. And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha. And that's 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 15 through 17. In the natural, we see, but can remain spiritually blind to what God is doing for us. When we ask God to open our spiritual eyes, the Holy Spirit will reveal many things to us in the spirit realm. When we begin to see spiritually, it will bless us immeasurably. In this passage, the young man was able to see that there was more of God's army than the Syrian army. Balaam, open our eyes regarding our shortcomings. And God's anger was kindled because he went, and the angel of the Lord stood in the way for an adversary against him. Now he was riding upon his ass, and his two servants were with him. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down under Balaam. And Balaam's anger was kindled, and he smote the ass with the staff. And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass. And she said unto Balaam, What have I done unto thee, that thou hast smitten me these three times? Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand. And he bowed down his head and fell flat on his face. And Balaam said unto the angel of the Lord, I have sinned, for I knew not that thou stoodest in the way against me. Now therefore, if it displeases thee, I will get me back again. Balaam was going his own way, not God's way. And that's Numbers chapter 22, verses 22 through 34. So in this context, he has opened Balaam's eyes to show that he has walked in the wrong path, and God has actually come out against him as an adversary because his way was perverse. Sometimes the Holy Spirit can give you a scripture and a sense that the way you are walking is not right. God is saying here that his children need their eyes open not only to the love, care, and provision of God, but also the fact that we stray and we err and we walk down paths that we shouldn't walk down. Then our eyes must be open to enable us to repent and get back on the right path. Missions application questions. Number one, why is spiritual sight important? Number two, what strategies will you use to increase your spiritual sight and spiritual revelation? Number three, which biblical passage or story used in this lesson is most meaningful to you and why? World Missions Prayer Points. Pray and ask God for the spirit of wisdom and revelation, and ask God to let the eyes of your understanding be enlightened. Pray Psalms 119, verse 18. Open thou my eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. The end. God bless you, and thank you for joining me today.